As the world watches, consider all that Canada and the United States share. A long-standing friendship, mutual respect for the environment, the world's largest trading relationship. America exports more to Canada than all European Union nations combined. Canada is America's largest energy provider, supplying oil from its vast oil sands and other reserves, natural gas and hydroelectric power, supporting millions of jobs on both sides of the border. Now that's something to celebrate.
And now from our Olympic studios in Vancouver, I'm Al Michaels, and I'm joined by Tom Brokaw. And Tom, of course, as you know, it's been so festive here for a number of days, and here we are on the day of the opening ceremony, and along comes the very sad and stunning news from Whistler earlier today.
Well, that was a tragic event. It was obviously very difficult to watch that video. It was a very sobering moment, but as you know, these Olympic athletes in the Winter Games will tell you that so many of their events are inherently dangerous. They're going 80, 90 miles an hour, not just on the luge or the bobsled run, but also the skiers and the downhill, the ski aerial performers. So there'll be a big pause, I think, for these athletes. But once the games begin, Al, knowing these competitors, they'll get about the business of competing against the greatest athletes in the world. And the rest of the world will have a chance to see the glories of this host country, Canada, and its very unique relationship with the United States.
This is the Peace Arch, standing near the westernmost edge of the U.S.-Canadian border, 30 miles south of the Olympic City, between Blaine and Washington State, and Surrey, British Columbia. This was dedicated in 1921 to commemorate the treaty that ended the War of 1812 between the U.S. and Great Britain. Remember, Canada was a British colony. That was a long time ago, but the inscription on the arch sums up the relationship. May these gates never be closed. We share more than a long border, of course. No dotted line can divide our joint stewardship of a treasure of natural riches. From the Atlantic to the Pacific, and back again. Shorelines, wild rivers, and great lakes, vast forests and grasslands. Precious ores buried in majestic mountains, and wildlife everywhere. From sea to shining sea. Canada and the United States share another unique quality. They're immigrant nations, destinations for people around the world who long for political freedoms, economic opportunity, and a long tradition of compassion. Our two nations have the largest trading relationship in the world. $1.5 billion transacted every day. The two-way trade at the Ambassador Bridge between Detroit and Windsor alone equals all American exports to Japan. And we're so comfortable as neighbors. 200 million people cross the common border every year. Canada, some may be surprised to learn, is America's largest oil supplier. And the United States is Canada's number one tourist destination. In a snapshot, Canada is a huge country, second largest in the world next to Russia. But its population is only about a tenth the size of the United States, 34 million. Split into 10 provinces and 3 territories. 90% of Canadians live within 100 miles of the U.S. border, residing in world-class cities, thriving farms and smaller towns. With good reason, life in the Canadian North is only for the hardy. It is remote and oh so cold. The coldest day ever recorded in North America occurred in 1947 in Snag, Yukon, minus 81 degrees, not including wind chill.
Jesse the Sponge.
Canadians are so generous, they share with us their brightest stars in music, comedy, acting, sports, and journalism. And if you're in a fight, you want the Canadians on your side. They were in World War II before we were. They were there on D-Day, in the air and on the beaches. They've been America's most reliable partners in Afghanistan, and it's been costly and painful. Now, when Canada loses a warrior in that distant land, the nation pauses and honors the fallen along what is called the Highway of Heroes outside of Toronto. Even their diplomats have been there for us. In 1980, a year before the conclusion of the Iranian hostage crisis, six American embassy personnel would escape from Iran in an operation organized by Canadian Ambassador Ken Taylor.
The United States is thanking Canada for rescuing those six American diplomats from Iran.
Taylor hid the Americans after the U.S. embassy was stormed, created fake Canadian passports, then flew the Americans out of Tehran with a bogus cover story. The six in disguise as a mob-looking Hollywood film crew allegedly researching a prospective sci-fi flick. Now, all these years later, Taylor has admitted he was formerly working for the CIA. And if the Iranians had discovered he was an American spy, he would have been in big, big trouble. In our darkest hours, Canada has been with us. On September 11th, as the United States shut down its airspace, Canada instituted Operation Yellow Ribbon, landing 239 U.S.-bound flights with 33,000 passengers at 17 different Canadian airports. And then, amid the uncertainty that followed, entire communities housed and fed those thousands of passengers for days afterward. In the long history of sovereign neighbors, there never has been a relationship as close, productive, and peaceful as the U.S. and Canada. We share a continent and so much more. Speaking before the Canadian Parliament, President Kennedy summarized the relationship this way.
Geography has made us neighbors. History has made us friends. Economics has made us partners. And necessity has made us allies.
Those whom nature hath so joined together, said Kennedy, let no man put asunder.